If you've ever driven, owned, or even thought of owning an electric car, the chances are that you've had at least one person come up to you at some point and say,
"Yeah, well, electric cars aren't clean, are they? They're not clean because they run on electricity. Where does electricity come from? It comes from coal. Yeah, you burn coal and make the electricity, and then you put it down the wires, and then it goes into the car. And of course, the batteries are toxic beyond belief. So personally, I would prefer to stick with my diesel. 1989, it's a good runner."
And then if you're like me, you sigh, take a deep breath, and try to tell them in as nice a possible way that studies have concluded, even with some coal mixed in, electric cars are still cleaner than petrol cars because of the current power grid mix. Know that the grid is getting cleaner, and remind them that a total of 6 kilowatt hours of electricity is used to refine every gallon of petrol. And then you remind them that most electric car owners do everything they possibly can to run their cars off renewable electricity from solar panels on the roof or a special green energy tariff. And then you sigh again because you know they're going to keep going on about the coal thing.
"I'm not driving one of those dirty electric cars. Coal powered they are."
But last Friday in the UK, something very special happened indeed. The UK national grid pulsed with electricity for an entire day without a single joule of it coming from a coal-powered fire station. What's more, it's the first time in 135 years that my home country hasn't burned coal to produce electricity for an entire day. Why is this so important? And what it means for the future of plug-in vehicles is coming up right next. Hi there, I'm Nikki Gordon-Bloomfield from Transport Evolved, and today we're celebrating the news that the UK's national electricity grid managed to run for a whole day last Friday without burning any coal, an important milestone as the country transitions its electricity generation mix away from fossil fuels and onto cleaner, greener alternatives. Unlike other parts of the world, where burning coal to produce electricity remains a mainstay of the power grid, the UK has been making a gradual shift away from coal power since the 1990s. Indeed, last year, the UK government announced that it intends to be completely coal-free by 2025, a move that will see more renewable electricity coming online to take up the slack, alongside renewed interest in nuclear power, as well as a continued shift towards power plants operating on natural gas. Now, I know what you're thinking. Natural gas is a fossil fuel, and you're right, it is. And on the face of it, extracting and burning natural gas for the purposes of electricity generation does produce greenhouse gas emissions. It's responsible for about half of the CO2 per kilowatt hour that coal emits. But while it's emissions, it's a step in the right direction. Obviously, a fully renewable grid made up of decentralized microgeneration, that's essentially everyone having their own set of photovoltaic solar panels on their roof and a battery backup system like a Tesla Powerwall in the garage, would be preferable. And we're certainly moving that way as a society, which is a very good thing for both electric car owners and society as a whole, because a cleaner grid means electric cars get cleaner to drive. In short, while petrol cars get more dirty as they age, as they become more inefficient and their engines become more and more worn, electric cars will get cleaner as they age, since the trend is towards cleaner generation methods for the electricity they rely on to operate. And that's already happening. In fact, back in 2015, a quarter of the UK's power needs were met by sources of renewable energy, outstripping coal for the first time. We're not even 2 years further down the line, and coal use is dwindling to insignificant amounts. Or to put it another way, electric cars driven and charged today in the UK are far, far more environmentally friendly than they were just 2 years ago. I've been checking the national grid demand this morning while writing the script for today's show, and coal is currently hovering at about 1.7% of all national electricity, while wind power is way up at nearly 16%. Being late evening in the UK, solar is only about 2%, but usually during the day it's much higher, with pumped storage, hydroelectric, and biomass all adding up to just under 8%. What about other power sources? Well, given the switch away from coal, natural gas has gone up between 2/5 and 1/2 on average, while nuclear power plants provide about 1/5 of all UK electricity. Now, nuclear does count as clean energy if we talk about emissions, but it does, of course, create all kinds of political and environmental problems when it comes to disposing of nuclear waste, not to mention the risks associated with plant failure or natural disasters. Three Mile Island, Chernobyl, and Fukushima have certainly taught us that. Right now, the UK government seems more interested in nuclear power and gas than anything else, but it doesn't mean the renewables aren't growing. Indeed, while natural gas and the fracking culture the UK government is keen to embrace could give the nation cheaper electricity for a while, there are some big problems with natural gas that means the UK does need to transition that natural gas generation to more sustainable solutions. For example, given natural gas contains a lot, and I do mean a lot of methane, if it's not properly extracted from the ground or handled correctly, it emits a butt ton of methane when put into the atmosphere, which is even better at trapping heat than carbon dioxide, so is definitely a problem for the planet. And as one 2013 academic paper for the fifth assessment report of the Intergovernmental Panel on Climate Change concluded, methane leaks from extraction and transportation of natural gas must be kept below 3.2% in order for natural gas to remain cleaner than coal, and only proper regulation will ensure that actually happens. Worse still, as the Union of Concerned Scientists point out, replacing coal and nuclear power with natural gas, which is a trend in several countries, won't have all of that major impact on total emissions. Yes, emissions will be less than they would be with coal, but they won't be reduced enough when combined with predicted electricity demand rises that have nothing to do with electric cars to make a difference to global warming. In other words, renewable energy needs to be the focus, and it's up to us to make sure it remains that focus moving forwards. As to coal and electric cars, and why Friday was so awesome, burning coal for electricity is inefficient and produces a lot of carbon dioxide. And because Friday didn't see any coal being burnt in the UK, an electric car charged on Friday in the UK was a lot cleaner than it was 2 years ago. And that's fantastic, and a thing worth celebrating. So what can you do as an electric car owner? Well, the first thing you can do is to sign up for a clean energy tariff if your local utility offers one. Make sure that you can charge your car from 100% renewable energy if you can, or pick a power mix that's as low as possible on fossil fuel energy. Second, consider saving up for your own micro generation at home, if you can, with photovoltaic solar panels and a battery backup system. And if you can't do that, consider investing in a local energy cooperative that works to promote renewables above all forms of energy. Do you feel better knowing that less energy is in the grid is coming from fossil fuels? Do you own an electric car? And where does the power come from that you use to power it? And what do you think of the energy mix of the future? What will it look like? Leave your thoughts in the comments below. Don't forget to like, comment, and subscribe. Tell your friends and family about the show. And if you liked what you saw today, please do consider helping me make more shows like this by making a monthly donation through Patreon. I've included a link below, and there's also a clickable one at the end of today's video. And finally, I'd like to thank the wonderful Robert Llewellyn for his cameo in today's video. Do check out his totally awesome Fully Charged channel, a link for which is also coming right up. I'll be back tomorrow, but until then, thanks for joining me. I'm Nikki Gordon-Bloomfield, and as always, keep evolving.